Here I have come with yet another bottle painting. In fact, two bottle paintings. One is with oil dispenser spout. So you can paint it on any bottle, need not be oil dispenser bottle, on any bottle you can paint. And another one is a simple one, which even kids can try this. So you might have watched my ladybug prop painting. So exactly the same method I have followed for these three pebbles. So I have stuck a few twigs. It's all the materials what we get from outside, so from our yard. So I got these twigs and pebbles, so I thought why not try this bottle. So this is a simple one, and this one, how it is different from a regular bottle to oil dispenser bottle is that we give gap for to check the level of the content inside with masking tape, and we use a dispenser spout. So that's the difference from a regular bottle. And here I've given a 3D effect for this nest. So this is very simple method. I've taken a simple lining cloth, any cotton cloth you can take and cut into a oval shape or a circle shape. So, and we stick it like this. So everything I have shown clearly in the video, and this I have painted. So in case if you have no time to paint this bird, and if you want to see the outcome, the result of the bottle really fast, what you can do is just you can take a printout of the bird and cut it and stick it, and we can follow the other method how it's shown in the video. So let's see how to make these two beautiful bottles. So let's get started.
This is my bottle which I have primed three times. Between each layer of priming I have given drying time at least 10 minutes, and the first two layers have used an old socks and I did dab, so it is little grainy, and the last coat I have used a brush. So I have put a masking tape here to see the content, the level of the content inside, and the artwork right opposite to where the masking tape is stuck. So for the bird I have given two oval as reference, one for head and one for body, and this is the piece of the cloth which we'll be using for to make the nest. It's a very any cloth, you can use any cloth, cotton, satin, anything. So now let's start by painting a background. No white is pure white, so I've added a little blue, brown or even black to make it look grayish. So this theme what I've chosen is a snowy winter theme, so this represents the snow, so it is white in color. Let's start with the underpaint. Mostly the underpaint would be darker in color, the darker than the subsequent layers. Whenever you are painting feathers, it's always better or advisable to start from the bottom, because if you start from the top, whenever you draw the bottom layers of feather, it will overlap and it doesn't look good. So let's start from the bottom. If you are a person who loves arts, craft or painting, or even if you love to watch them, please do subscribe to my channel. And when you subscribe, please do click on the bell icon, so whenever I upload a new video, you get notification and you don't miss any of the videos I upload. For the nest, I have taken an oval shaped cloth. It's a little bigger than what I showed in the beginning. And let's start by gluing it to the bottle. You can use Mod Podge, but it takes a lot of time to dry. So I always suggest you to use the glue gun. So first you fold it and put the first application of glue gun. And then let's just slide on the bottle and then start gluing it up. If you do pleats, it won't look like a natural nest. And so it's always better to slide to get that 3D nest effect. And let's keep gluing it. And when it comes to the end, to the seam, let's fold and just glue them. Let's apply a little Mod Podge over that because it preserves or it retains the shape of it when the Mod Podge dries. It stays permanently the nest shape. So when the Mod Podge is still wet, let's apply some color to it. I've used yellow ochre. You can use any light brown color and a little dark in between just to show the depth. For a chatting ladybug bottle, I have taken a glue gun, and with the help of glue gun, I'll be sticking these twigs onto the bottle. I always advise to use these kind of twigs, little smaller, which is a little flexible. I've used a regular tissue paper here. I've split open it and I started sticking with the Mod Podge. And let's do the same method for the whole bottle. Here, let's try not to put a lot of Mod Podge, it might tear. So in case if you want to do the second layer of tissue paper, you have to let the first layer completely dry. So once it is dry, I applied another layer of Mod Podge over that. So it helps to retain that twigs in the right place. Also the paper, it never peels off when we put a second layer of Mod Podge over that. Once the Mod Podge is completely dry, let's put gesso over that. Let's just paint gesso or any white paint, because we are painting on that. If you're just letting it as it is without giving any yellow or orange or the sunset color, you can just let it as it is and you can just start gluing up the ladybug. So meanwhile, our gesso is getting dried. Let's paint our ladybugs. I have a detailed video of this ladybug in another video called Rock Painting Ladybug.
Sit together, it's so beautiful, you and me, we meant to be in the great outdoors, forever free. Take a step back to see the truth around you. From a distance you can tell.
Thank you so much for watching today's video. Hope you like today's video. If you like, please do like, share and subscribe. Bye bye. Take care. Until we meet next time. It's so beautiful.